By this time tomorrow, we hope to be counting down to the second attempt of the Artemis 1 launch.
Yeah, in a briefing last night, NASA says they're still on target for liftoff tomorrow afternoon, with that launch window opening at 2:17. Monday's launch, of course, scrubbed over some issues involving a rocket engine that could not be cooled down for final fueling. Engineers now say the issue was a sensor reading. Meanwhile, new here in news, scientists say that they've made a major breakthrough to fight to save our coral reefs. It's a historic step forward, breeding elkhorn coral.
Yeah, the Florida Aquarium says it is now the first in the world to reproduce this threatened coral. This spawning produced a couple thousand corals. The species lives right at the top of the reef crest, meaning it plays a really big role in protecting our coastline from devastating storm surge. But getting them to reproduce isn't as easy as you would think.
When you have an endangered pandas or chimpanzees, the first thing you do is start a breeding program. But coral reproduction is super weird. There is hope for coral reefs. Don't give up hope. It all is not lost.
Now, this breakthrough is just a first step. The goal is a breeding program where they could ultimately breed more resilient coral. Glenn?
That's pretty amazing. We've done a few coral reef stories recently, and all of it's amazing. All right, let's track the tropics. We'll get right down to it. Danielle was a tropical storm yesterday. This morning, it became the first hurricane of the season with winds at 75 miles per hour. So it crossed that threshold of 74 miles per hour. That's the beginning parameter for hurricane force winds, and it's expected to strengthen over the next couple of days. When we take a look at the track from the 11 a.m. advisory from the National Hurricane Center, you'll see it kind of looks a little blobby down at the bottom here, and then the cone becomes very wide, and that's because there's a lot of different computer models going a lot of different directions here. But the good news about Danielle is it stays out to sea. It doesn't bother anybody. Shipping channels may have to divert a little bit and change course, but other than that, it's not going to bother anyone. All right, let's take a look at what else is going on in the tropics. Got a little area of low pressure over here by the Cape Verde Islands, that with only a 10% chance for development now, and a 70% chance for development for this disturbance just to the east of the Leeward Islands here. Some computer models do have this strengthening into a named storm over the weekend, but as it moves up toward the U.S., it curves back out to sea for most of the computer models, so it does not look like a threat to land. Let's take a look at what's going on locally. As we check out the weather headlines for today at Jensen Beach, we're going to see very pretty scenes from across the area, limited cloud cover because drier air is moving in. So we had the first hurricane of the season. We've got strong storms and heavy rain in the forecast today, but only for a limited part of our viewing area, and then decreasing chances for rain as we get into the weekend and more dry air starts to move into South Florida. When we look up to our north, we do have plenty of shower and thunderstorm activity off to the west and northwest and northeast coasts of Florida. But in our area, it's very, very light when it comes to rainfall. We've had a couple of showers bubbling up. If you watched yesterday, we had a whole line of showers and storms developing at this time. Not today, just a few pop-up showers here and there. I haven't even seen any lightning data, although it's not impossible for a couple of thunderstorms to develop over the next couple of hours. And then inland this afternoon, a higher chance for showers and storms developing out around Lake Okeechobee. Some rainfall could be heavy. Tomorrow, rain chances go down even more. We could see some rain along the coast in the morning, and then again, it pushes inland in the afternoon, only about a 20% chance, and that continues on Sunday with maybe even less than a 20% chance for rain. So we go from 30 to 20 to 20 to 20, maybe even closer to 10 in a few spots as we get into the end of the weekend and the beginning of next week. Temperatures right now are in the low 90s, which is right around average for this time of year. We'll top out in the low 90s today. Rain chances become pretty limited as we continue into Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. A little bit of moisture starts to trickle back in late Wednesday, with rain chances going up toward the end of next week. That's a look at your first warning forecast.
Glenn, thank you. Well, we have some exciting news to share. Starting next week, you can sample a special week-long program right here on WPBF 25.
Yeah, it's called Very Local Presents, More to Explore. You can watch full episodes of these shows with popular stars beginning on Monday. You can see the original entertaining reality shows courtesy of the Very Local free streaming service. Shows will start at 3 p.m., and that's on Monday on WPBF 25.
This is exciting too. College football back right here on WPBF 25 this weekend, and we have three great matchups to bring you. So first at noon, the 8th ranked Michigan Wolverines kicking off their season at the Big House with what they hope will be kind of a tune-up game against Colorado State. Then at 3:30, a top 25 matchup, number 11 Oregon and the reigning national champs, Georgia Bulldogs. And then we're upping the ante even more at 7:30. This is going to be a big one.
That's going to be a good one.
Yeah,
here.
Number 5 Notre Dame takes on number 2 Ohio in week 1. Okay. It should be a real prove it game, if you will, for the Fighting Irish. So
that's going to be on in our house for sure. Well, here's a sign that summer is coming to an end. Universal's Orlando's Halloween Horror Nights is back.
Oh, here we go. It's running for 43 nights through Halloween. There are 10 immersive haunted houses and 5 scary zones, each filled with menacing creatures. There will be 2 live show guests to catch, and Universal says it's best to buy your tickets in advance because some nights, get this, are already sold out.
I believe it, and I've been hearing incredible things
really?
About this year's Halloween Horror Nights. Well, now here's a look at what's coming up on WWE.